Typhoon Hagupit, in fact, right now making landfall across northeastern part of Samar Island here. I think Oras is going to be the place where we're going to be talking about the technical landfall. That is the center of the storm, what would be the eye going right over the extreme northeastern tip here. And now we're experiencing the brunt of the storm, no question about it, with this ring that extends out from the center. That's where we're going to find the typhoon force winds. At the center of the storm, right around at 205 kilometer per hour winds as of the latest advisory from the Joint Typhoon Warning Center. Our computer model forecast, take a look at this. These are the core winds. That is the wind field that is going to be very dangerous coming on shore and then continuing over the next few days heading off to the north and west. It is pouring. Rainfall rates are incredible right now, and so this is going to lead to flash flooding and certainly mudslides and landslides over the next few days. Tacloban right here, and you see these bands. Those bands can contain typhoon force winds as we continue to see this thing moving on in. And in fact, we're going to be in that over the next several hours, so that by 24 hours, it moves through Legazpi, and then in 48 hours headed off to the north and west, approaching Manila with gusty winds, certainly strong winds enough to cause damage. But I think by the time we are talking Manila there, it's going to be more of a rain event here. But across the northeast, there it is, and moving certainly to the north and west. My concern still with Legazpi will be the storm surge. As the storm moves north and west, we could see that push of water up to the bay there, and that is going to be causing the significant damage potential there, certainly. And then, of course, raining very heavily all the while. We'll keep you posted. Stay with us.